Now, I have to ask, Natalie, have you seen the new Star Wars movies?
No.
Oh, well, they're really good. They're much better than...
Better than what?
Say something about the mother... Prinkles, bitch!
They were good!
Say something nice about Jar Jar Binks!
He's tall!
Now, kiss him right on his 17!
What?
While I sit dead on your face and take it!
Yes, poco tú, that please, that tengo. Yeah, Oscar!
Yes, I bet you have.
Welcome back to the Cantina. This is Stephanie, your friendly neighborhood Wookiee Wrangler, scoundrel coordinator, a chaos coordinator, bar manager, bar owner, speaker of Star Wars lore, whatever. I'll talk to you guys a little bit about why Hollywood, for all intents and purposes, is dead. There will be some people arguing with me. Go for it. A few years back, and you can find this on YouTube, I think. It is a lecture slash talk that Steven Spielberg, George Lucas gave to students, I think at the USC Film School, or UCLA Film School, one of them. And they were basically saying, era of the blockbuster's dead. How can that be? Let's talk about this. A movie that is supposed to be big, brought larger than life, that can sit at the theater for months, is a blockbuster. A movie that might make $200 million in the first weekend, and then, you know, peter off by 50, 60, you know, 75%, is not a blockbuster. It might make $1 billion, it's not a blockbuster. The reason why is because people don't go back to go see it. And in fact, the average general audience now does not go to the theater. Why? Well, Spielberg and Lucas talked about technology, how technology has changed. You can set up a beautiful media room in your basement, in a room in your house, have the sound everywhere, have a huge screen TV, watch Blu-rays, watch Netflix, watch, you know, movies coming up and on demand. You don't need to go to a theater, spend $30, $40 on one ticket and popcorn or whatever, to see a movie. Now, the experience is different. I do prefer to go to the theater with get my popcorn and glass of pop soda and sit down and watch a good movie. It's not just technology that keeps people away. Let me explain what keeps people away from the theaters. Reboots, remakes, bad storytelling, condescending political lectures by people who don't know what they're talking about and have no clue and are so disconnected from real life, they would be lost in 7-Eleven. They wouldn't know what to do. That's a problem. That's a big goddamn problem. When you have Jonah Hill yesterday coming out saying that the movie industry won't change until white men are all gone. Here's a picture of Jonah Hill. Really, Jonah? Have you looked at yourself in the mirror lately? You're basically trying to cancel yourself out of your job, you dumb ass. Okay. Have that. Mark Hamill, Luke Skywalker. I still love him. I don't get the political nonsense he spews. But what's an old hippie gonna do? You know, on Twitter and Instagram, attacking the president day after day after day after day. Sarah Silverman. Ugh. Horrible woman. Lena Dunham. Rosie O'Donnell. Alec Baldwin, Billy Baldwin, Robert De Niro, Bette Midler, Barbara Streisand, whom, you know, has been doing that for the last 50 years. I just remember her going to Democrat things and attacking Reagan when I was in high school and me going, no one cares what you think. Shut up. Just sing, you stupid bitch. All right. All this is a problem. It doesn't help that Ron Howard does it. It doesn't help that Tom Hanks, he's not as mean, but he does it too. It doesn't help that Taika Waititi does it. It doesn't help. It doesn't help that Bob Iger does it. Okay? Here's the deal, guys. When you attack President Trump, you attack his voters as being mouth-breathing, hillbilly, rednecks, racists, which is what you do. Because, you know, again, you're disconnected from all reality. And this, you live in an echo chamber that is narrow, small, to go along with your narrow vision of the world. You're turning off the country. You're even turning off liberals who don't want to hear it now. And I don't mean liberals like me. I mean leftist liberals who are like, you know, there's a reason why Ricky Gervais said what he said. Real film.
Superb drama, yeah. A superb drama about the importance of dignity and doing the right thing, made by a company that runs sweatshops in China. So, well, you say you're woke, but the companies you work for, I mean, unbelievable. Apple, Amazon, Disney. If ISIS started a streaming service, you'd call your agent, wouldn't you? So, if you do win an award tonight, don't use it as a platform to make a political speech, right? You're in no position to lecture the public about anything. You know nothing about the real world. Most of you spent less time in school than Greta Thunberg. So, if you win, right, come up, accept your little award, thank your agent and your God, and f*** off, okay? So...
why would I, who worked on Capitol Hill as a staffer for a congressman, who happened to be the House Majority Leader at the time, who has actually met some of your heroes, Adam Schiff, he was there when I was there, Nancy Pelosi, yada, 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 et cetera, et cetera. Why would I take anything that you disconnected? 90% of you are unremarkable people. Seriously, okay? I know how the government works because I worked there. I worked not only for on the legislative side, I worked for the executive branch, okay? You can't tell me much, if anything, about fucking Washington, D.C. or how the country should be governed, okay? Because unlike you, I live in America, all right? I don't surround myself with people who, you know, say the same shit that I do. You know, the real world is, even amongst, let's say, Trump's children, they don't all agree. Shocked? Why? It's true. Okay, so let's talk about this. What's wrong with Hollywood? Why is it dying? Well, that, what I just talked about, the uncouth, angry, out of bounds insanity dribbling out of these people's mouths. Shut up. Another thing, the reason why Hollywood's dying, blacklisting people that don't agree with them. I have friends who've been blacklisted. I have friends who've left Hollywood because of it. Protecting, you know, directors that sexually harass not only actresses, but actors, other writers. Okay. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. You know, I know the casting couch has existed ever since, you know, the moment motion pictures were invented. You know, Louise Brooks, Clara Bow, you know, Brooks dancing on a bar in some old silent movie. That shit was going on back then. Why am I shocked by Harvey Weinstein? You know? Why am I shocked by Bryan Singer? I'm not, because it's what happens. What I'm shocked about is a lack of responsibility and lack of self-confidence and belief in themselves of these actresses that actually bought, if you fuck me, I'll put you in this movie. You actually bought that. Let me tell you something. You know what I call women that do that? That exchange economic benefits for sex? I call them prostitutes. Whores. Asia Argento, Rose McGowan. You know, I'm not saying that Harvey Weinstein didn't rape girls. We know he did. All right? He's a predator. But I'm going to say something. Some of you did this on purpose. And you didn't get what you wanted. So this is your revenge on Harvey. Okay? And as for the people who knew about it, Oprah Winfrey. Really, Oprah? Here's a picture. Honestly, Oprah looks like she's pimping that girl to him. Every time I see this picture, I shudder. And the reason why is this. That girl does not know what the fuck is going on around her. She's either gonna be part of the Me Too thing that takes down Oprah, and you can goddamn right that happened, or she's part of the Me Too that took down Harvey Weinstein. They all knew about it. You could have at least told them to stop it, but you didn't. Why? You know, I've got a director friend named Lee who talks at length about girlfriends he had that will come home crying about casting directors telling them, well, you know, if you fuck the director, man or woman, they'll give you the part. I've got friends who have good stories about Bryan Singer. Now he's hiding, right? James Gunn. He's on video begging a girl to give him anal sex. Here we are talking about this, and you wonder why Hollywood is dead. You know, you lecture the rest of us on how we live. Attack President Trump for something he didn't do, Stormy Daniels. And he wouldn't do Stormy Daniels because she's disgusting and he, bleh. I mean, Donald Trump, if anything, was a very intelligent connoisseur of beautiful women, and she is not one, okay? You know, you basically project what you've done to girls on him, all right? You get upset with locker room talk. Real men talk like that. I guarantee you, you've heard it, if you're a man. And if it offends you, I want you to do this for me. To have your testosterone to soy ratio tested, okay? Really, you need to. Then we get told, you know, of the over-sexualizing of women and that women are dressed too provocatively in movies. And then we get the Super Bowl halftime show. The two middle-aged broads who, if they didn't have money, would probably not look like that, wiggling their butts around, grabbing their crotches. Me Too movement. Where are the feminists? And half the feminists I know are applauding them because they're showing the power of Latinas. It's all up here, lady. Your, how you look is gonna fade. It's here, right there, you dumb bitch. Don't teach your daughters that. Self-respect is everything for a woman. Modesty, to a point, at least, is the right course. Men will respect you. They won't think of you as just a pair of legs, tits, and a you-know-what, okay? Men will appreciate you. They will take care of you. They will honor you. They will go to war for you. Some chick, like Jennifer Lopez, 51 years old, she's my age, pole dancing at the Super Bowl. Sure, the drunk guys at the Super Bowl are appreciating what she's doing, but all she has is a pair of tits, an ass, and a pussy. That's it. That's it. And a big ass is that. Same thing with Shakira. And yet, it's empowering to be sexy. And yet, if you dress like that in a movie, then you get shot down. What the hell is up with that? Another thing that's going on that's wrong, before I'm done. Where are the authentically masculine men? Where? I don't see any. Matt Damon is not authentically masculine. Ben Affleck is laughable. Chris Pine, the Hemsworth brothers, Leonardo DiCaprio. The only actor that is a fairly big star nowadays who's could lay claim to that I can think of is Keanu Reeves, but it's because of what happened to him after he got famous. He was involved with a girl. They were going to get married. She got pregnant. She lost the baby. They broke up. Heartbreaking. She died in a car accident. Okay, that's really heartbreaking. His sister got cancer. The man you see now is not the same guy from Bill and Ted's Excellent Adventure. He is completely different. He's completely different from the guy in The Matrix. All right. Authentic masculinity. Let's talk about the movie stars of the past and compare them to Matt Damon, Chris Pine, the Hemsworth brothers, and the rest of this dumpster fire of humanity that we've got as actors now. John Wayne. John Wayne, when he got to Hollywood in the 20s, moved furniture and broke down and built stages, sets, movie sets. Okay. Worked with his hands. Clint Eastwood was not only in the army, a helicopter he was on went down over the ocean and he had to swim back. Steve McQueen, juvenile delinquency, broken family, abuse, neglect, spent time in juvenile in jail for it. Some of the stuff he did. The man you saw in the movies was partially made by the sad things that he went through and that he survived. You can see it in his eyes. Authentically masculine. Already been there, done that. Harrison Ford worked as a carpenter to support his family while waiting, trying to get roles as an actor. Had a few bit parts in the 60s. Had some genius level Hollywood suit tell him to go back to being a carpenter because he'd never make it big in Hollywood. Hey, Harrison Ford here, okay? Let's take a look. It's the biggest movie star of all time, box office alone. Biggest box office draw, okay? Still relevant after 40 years, all right? Everything that made him the man that we see in the movies was outside of the acting profession. Let's compare that with Adam Driver. Adam Driver was a Marine for 4 years. I think four. Got into a mountain bike accident and got medically discharged. As far as I know, if you don't have campaign ribbons, you're not a veteran. Now, maybe I'm wrong. Maybe someone can explain that to me. But I'm going to say this. Know a lot of Marines in my life. A lot. My husband was in command of a battalion. He was in command of a regimental-sized battalion. It was his colonel's command. 2,000 men. I've known enlisted guys. I've known their wives. I've known young officers. I've known general officers, their wives. I know Marines. Okay, this was my life for the last 14 years. Since 2004. The day we got married, right after that, he took over command of 1st Battalion, 12th Marines. My first experience with the Marine Corps. I was scared out of my mind. Know a lot of stories about them. You got your good Marines, and you got your guys that make you go, oh my God. So when I hear, well, he's a Marine, you have to like him. I'm like, I don't know him. I'm sorry. He doesn't have the authentic, real masculinity that Harrison Ford and Keanu Reeves, even Brad Pitt to a point, has. I think the road for him was not as tough as it has been for them. He's not an attractive man in any way, shape, or form. I don't find him... I can't look at Adam Driver and go, ooh. I look at Adam Driver and go, ew. I don't get it. What is going to happen with his career? Well, you know, he got an Oscar nomination for A Marriage Story, which looks like a giant... I could give two shits about any of the characters in it. He's not playing a real man. He's playing a Broadway producer. You know, I mean, first off, that's kind of a step out of character because aren't most Broadway producers gay? I mean, just asking. It's a story that I really don't see anybody being interested in. And I really do think that Kylo Ren and Star Wars have probably hurt his career. Why do I think that? I can't look at him without seeing Kylo Ren murder his father. I can't. I can't look at him without that. And I don't like him because of it. I don't like Adam Driver because of it. I don't like Adam Driver because I don't think he's that good of an actor, even if he spent money and wasted his time at Juilliard when he didn't have to. All right. I don't like Adam Driver because of that role, because of his role in Girls, which is, you know, the cheap knockoff, slutty version of Sex and the City. I didn't like him because of his fans. Okay. I don't know where he's going to go. Now, I've talked to friends about this. My friend Dan Watanabe and I talked about it. And he doesn't like him either. And Dan is a movie connoisseur. He is an historian. He's worked for studios. Okay? He's done a lot in the system. And he doesn't think that Adam's career is going to go anywhere. You know? I don't like him. But... this is the kind of guy that right now Hollywood is depending on to put butts in seats. A guy that has absolutely no charisma, no physical masculinity that is attractive to a real woman, no appeal. Liam Hemsworth is real pretty, but Chris Hemsworth, real pretty, but Chris Pine. You know, Matt Damon, ick. Ben Affleck, ick. I mean, there's something lacking in them that 60, 70 years ago would have been noticed right away, and it's authentic masculinity. You know, you can't take a look at a guy like Matt Damon and then put him up against a guy like William Holden. You can't. You can't take a guy like Adam Driver and put him up against a movie star like Steve McQueen. You can't. Because Adam Driver does not bring to the screen what a guy like Steve McQueen did. All right? Doesn't bring to the screen what Harrison Ford brings. It's another reason why Hollywood's dead. Hollywood is dead because of the way the fans are being treated. Shitty scripts, shitty writing, reboots, remakes, technology, this Me Too crap, and the left-wing diatribes, all these wackos go on, the lack of a real male movie star. That is all I have to say. See you on the galaxy, see you on the cantina. Remember, tip the Wookiee bartenders 20%. No droids, no bounty hunters, no Raylos. No, you didn't get what you wanted, you fucking bitches. Go away now. Start a fight. Allie, gunfights, you take that shit out in the street. Start the galaxy's gonna